Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Gospel is for the twice-born people and not for the once-born people of the book. The once-born people, what is written in the Bible, they just vomit it out without understanding. Whereas the twice-born people, they look into the deep, into the gospel hidden under them. And here is, I'm doing today, gospel, Mark 7, verse 31 to 37. It's a holy gospel of Jesus. It's wrong to say Jesus Christ. It's Jesus the Christ, the anointed Christ. That is better, you know. And Christ is the title. Jesus is the name. Then he returned from the region of Tyre and went by way of Sidon towards the Sea of Galilee in the region of the Decapolis. They brought to him a deaf man who had an impediment in his speech. Now, this is important, you know. We should do what is allegorically, what is deaf symbolized. Remember that the priest, rabbis, they were all in all. If somebody questioned them, you know, they will make him shut down. They were lords of the village or of the town. Whatever, like Pope, you know, whatever Pope said, no question asked, otherwise your head will be chopped off. So such were the rabbis. They kept their disciple. Disciple mean, the root of the disciple is from discipline. Discipline, natural man you discipline through prayers and fasting. So the once-born laborers of the rabbis, they are disciple and they do fasting and praying. Remember when Jesus was eating at the place of Matthew, some of these Pharisees Sadducees came, hey, your laborers don't pray or fast as those of the rabbis. So rabbis had the laborer, but these crook messianic Jews, when they enter the church, they bring in their old practices of the temple. Remember the parable of the wine press? When they were sacked, they were good for nothing. The wine press was the Jerusalem temple when it was destroyed. So they were good for nothing. They said, oh, let's go back to our old customer, Matthew 12. Verse 43 to 45. And they jumped over the wall of the church of God, entered the church, and they found it empty. Empty mean that there was no priest over there. And when there was no priest, they were clever, psychic. Hey, we got the praise. Now we got the prey. That means our birds of the air. Birds, you know. And then they impose their own views and start again teaching Torah. And then presbyters came who were teaching the letters of the New Testament, and they corrupted it. And where we are laborers, they made us disciples. Same old system. Laborers are solitary, independent workers. And so they kept those rabbis, kept their congregation mute. They were not allowed to speak or question him. And deaf. They were not allowed to listen to anybody else. Today you can see, go to a monastery. And I went to Romania and I went to monastery and I tried to give my leaflet to a nun over there. She said, No, no, we can't take your leaflet. Our, what they call them, Abbott. Abbott, he has told us not to take any material from anyone that is mute, that is called mute. In Jesus, we are neither deaf, we can hear, and we are neither mute, we can preach gospel. And that is what the message is, that he put fingers in our ears to open our ears, and he spit from his own mouth onto the tongue. That means what came out of the mouth of Jesus, we become like him, preachers of gospel. So they brought to him a deaf man, deaf made by the rabbis, not deaf this one. This was symbolic. Who had an impediment in the speech, and they begged him to lay his hand on him. He took him aside in private. Took him aside in private, mean the person who want to preach gospel, who is honored by Christ, honored by God, he's solitary. That's why he was taken away from the crowd. That means he's not part of the crowd. One in a thousand and two in 10,000 will know gospel altogether.